Hi friends, today I'm gonna share a technique with you. Today's technique is about switching between modes, like computer modes, phone modes, or other things mode. You know, sometimes we the phone users need to see our website, how it performs on phone, or you may not have iPhone on your hand, but you want to check your website how works on iPhone. Then it becomes quite tough fact for you. Or if you have iPhone but you don't have any Android right now, then it makes a problem. So how can we switch or use different kinds of handset or different kind of platforms on our PC? You may think that you may need some kind of hardware. Probably no, you don't need any hardware. You need some techniques for this. Like let's see, YouTube. Let's go to youtube.com. Okay, YouTube is coming, loading. We are playing it from PC. So you see here is the PC version. Okay, here is the PC version. Now how we can see or check that how it looks on phone? There is a trick on net that is called Chrome. Chrome mobile responsive mode. Okay, Chrome, Chrome responsive mode. Chrome responsive extension, or whatever this is, Chrome responsive mode. Let's see how to do this. They say it. You want to do this. This is a pretty much nasty thing, you know. What to do is you should on the website, then click the developer mode, like more tools. Developer tools, and now this will bring something like this, and there you see a phone design. Click that phone. Now you see a phone mode. You will see this phone mode, but this thing doesn't work for long. If I cross this thing, it may gone now. Okay, it is not here. It's gone. Pretty much problem. This is a problem, and I want it for long, but no chance. So, how to solve this problem? So let's check another time how it looks. Now this is not gonna work. This is not gonna work for me. So how to solve about this problem? Well, we have to take another easy method. It's a Chrome extension. What is Chrome extension? Chrome extension is something like additional programs. You will find this from click here and go to more tools and go to extensions. You will see these additional things are added on Chrome, and as a result you can perform these tasks like sheets. If you want to open Google Documents or you want to open some kind of Excel sheets, you can open them by Chrome. Chrome can open these things by this additional support. Now what you have to do, just go to Google, Google you don't remember, just write isn't switcher. Okay, isn't switcher Chrome. Now see, there you will find a plugin named user agent switcher for Chrome. Now click this extension, it will bring you this web address. I don't know whether user agent switcher for Mozilla is out there or not. We'll check it later, but let's check this for Chrome, how this thing works. Well, okay, we are on the Chrome page right now. Now here you see a button. Now click add to Chrome, add extension. Okay, we're gonna add this extension. Okay, it gives you a notice, user agent switcher for Chrome has been added to Chrome. Good. Remove from Chrome, we're not gonna remove it, we're gonna use it. So let's see how it works. You don't need to refresh, it's already added. I can cut it, bring a new tab. Now let's check the extension space, more tools, extensions. Where is that extension? There is it, user agent switcher for Chrome. Let's see details. Okay, it is on. Now how to use this? Okay, how to use this? Just click here, you see user agent switcher from Chrome. Okay, click. Now you will find many options here. It says Chrome, Internet Explorer, iOS, Android, Windows Phone, Firefox, Opera, Safari. Now if we click on Internet Explorer, it will act like Internet Explorer would do. Let's click it. Let's check with Internet Explorer 10. If our browser was Internet Explorer 10, then how it perform? It will show us. Now you see it's YouTube is saying that youtube.com supported browsers, please update your browser. That means YouTube doesn't support Explorer 10 right now, so it is giving us this notice. Okay, though we are using Chrome, but it is thinking that our request is from Explorer 10. Okay, if now we click on iOS, iOS means iPhone 6. Now let's check how it acts. Delete youtube.com and refresh. Now you see it looks like this. Okay, if it was from iPhone, then it would perform like this. Let's check iPad. Okay, iPad. If it was iPad, then it would act or it would be seen like this. Okay, now let's check Android KitKat. It only have Android KitKat version, so let's switch to Android KitKat and how it would look on Android KitKat. Okay, it would be look like this. Now let's check it with Windows Phone 8. If it was Windows Phone, then it will be something look like this. Now let's check it with Firefox 33. It's loading. think it has been loaded. It would be something look like this on Firefox. Let's switch it to Safari. If it was Mac Safari, how it would look? Okay, on Mac Safari it would look like this. So I have checked this thing from by this extension, and now question is whether it looks the search engine or YouTube, how it thinks it is browsing. Like if I click to Windows Phone, does YouTube really thinks it is Windows Phone 8? Is it true? Now to prove is I have to do some works. Okay, let's switch it to default user agent switcher. At first we should go to default. Okay, let's set it to default. Now let's check our IP. You can check your IP from many websites. My favorite is whoair.net. I check my IP from this website. Let's see what is our IP. Okay, our IP is 103.15.14.067. It's called Bangladesh, and our IP is ICC communication. Okay, and hostname is nothing. OS is Windows 7 and browser is Chrome 9.7. Now let's change our browser setting. We may switch it to Android KitKat. Okay, Android KitKat. Our browser is on Android KitKat mode. Now let's refresh this page to see whether it is Android or not. Now we are checking. We see that it is checking our browser, and the fun begins. Our IP is correct, and you see it's acting like a VPN 172.217, and it's like from India, and our OS is from Android. Okay, funny, isn't it? Android Nexus 4, Chrome 34. Okay, OS is Android and the browser is Chrome 34. Now let's check more. We can try it with Opera. Let's check it with iOS. Okay. Okay, it's reloaded. Now we refresh our page. IP is same and it is thinking about from India. It's not a problem, but OS operating system, you see now iOS, iPhone, and it is taking support from Safari 6.0. So if you want to check how it performs or any problem, or if you want the browser thing to check something like Internet Explorer environment, iOS environment, or Android environment, or Windows Phone, or Firefox, or Opera, or Safari environment, then you can use this extension and have the fun. This is so light extension, but will work pretty much good. Now let's remove this extension, and okay, it's removed. Now let's check with another interesting extension for you. Let's check. Let me show you. If you are from what to say, if you are a VPN user, then you may need VPNs to use regularly, but you sometimes have a great problem with IPs. Okay, the IPs are same, or the browser is asking for money, give us money, be paid, then you are in a problem. You are on hurry, you just need to open a website, but you can't do it. The software providers are asking for money, give us money, give us money, give us money. Then what to do? What VPN you can use? Then today I'm gonna share you a good VPN. You may be happy with them. Okay, let's jump in. Search on Google for Browsec Browsec VPN for Chrome. You can go to Browsec VPN for Chrome. Okay, it will take you Browsec Chrome somewhere to Chrome's website. Let's click it. Okay, it is opening. You will see Browsec VPN, free VPN for Chrome, or you can go to browsec.com. okay, directly go to browsec.com. okay, here is this browsec.com. you can click install, and say it will bring you to the similar page. Okay, Browsec VPN to Chrome. You can go to directly also. Okay, let's test it. Just click add to Chrome, add extension. It will be added. It's working, you see. It's going to add. Okay, okay, it says that this browser has been added to our browser. Now how to use this? Now just go to this icon, seems something like this icon, and hit it, and it will say start VPN. If you are a free user, you will get only three countries. They are four countries: Netherlands, Singapore, United Kingdom, and United States. You should click on the country that is getting much more strength. Like now, we have Singapore. Singapore has best strength, so select it. We are connected. Pretty much easy, right? Now we are connected to Singapore, and we will use Singapore's IP. Okay, let's check that it is working or not. Again, we are going to whoair.net. Now let's see what is our IP location browser is. Okay, you see the flag is looking like Singapore. ISP is Lesweb Asia, DNS is Singapore, hostname not applicable, OS is Windows 7, browser is correct, Chrome 97.0, but country is Singapore, and IP is different, and ISP also different. So this is working perfectly. Now if we switch our VPN, now what happens? Like we can choose it to Netherlands. Let's see what happens. Okay, we just refresh whoair.net. Now let's see what happens. Okay, you see that the flag is something like Netherlands, ISP is FDC servers, hostname is not applicable, OS 27, Chrome 90.7, and the country is Netherlands. So this thing works. If you are happy, then you can buy their paid services. That is awesome service. I have checked it, only their free service that is providing only three countries, four countries: Netherlands, Singapore, United Kingdom, and United States. But you will get lots of country IP here: Australia, Belgium, Brazil, lots of countries there. You see, India, Israel. So, if you want much more countries to VPN, then you can buy their packets. They are very good, I think, on service. Okay, how to shut down this plugin, sorry, extension? Just go here again and go to, you can click here or you can click this three dot also. Now go now click remove from Chrome, remove data. This is removed. The plugin is removed now. Now let's check what is our IP now. You see, it's back our it's back ICC communication, Windows 7, Bangladesh. Okay, so I think it's a very good plugin for extension for you to change your country, or if your country is blocking websites for you, and it's quite good. It doesn't want money every time, or it doesn't give huge advertise for you. It's simple, no registration is needed, just install it and you go. Now let's check it with another browsers like Firefox. Let's see, we don't have Firefox, so we have to install it. Let's install it, Firefox. Okay, we're gonna install the Firefox. Okay, it will start. Let it to be installed. As it installs, I'm gonna share with you another good plugin for you. Like if you have a slow speed internet, like say let's go to video, like me at the zoo. Let's see a video. Okay, free copy right video. Okay, let's find a free copyright video. Let's go to my channel. Okay. Okay. Let's go to this channel now. Here you see there are lots of videos. Let's open a video. Let's turn off the sound. Here the video resolution is 720 sometimes it is much more higher. Let's see another video, what resolution it is. It's 720, but if your net line or net connection is slower, then what you would do? Then what you do? Like, you need to play it on 144 or 240, then you have to select every time the quality, but this is a hassle. So you can install a plugin or a extension that can help you. Like, go to Chrome, go to google.com and write, sorry, I mistake. Go to google.com and type auto quality for YouTube Safari. It's not Safari, it's Chrome. Auto quality for YouTube Chrome. Then you will get a result like this. Go to it and just install it. Add to Chrome. Click Add to Chrome. You will find this red gear symbol and install it. Add to extension. You see it's installing on the background. Now it's installed and this page comes. I'm gonna cut it and you go here. This icon. And you see auto quality for YouTube, but it's not, it seems not like active, it seems like turn off, because it works when the YouTube page comes. Okay, it doesn't seems active or it doesn't show active icon on another pages. When YouTube comes, you go to this icon and you will click this page, and now see it's working. It will ask for default quality. Okay, we'll give default quality of 140, or you can set it as you want, like 240, and then hit save. Okay, for the first time, you don't need it to do on future. Okay, like if you go to another video right now, let's see.
This is how fast YouTube is with Break. Notice how there's no pre-roll ads? And here's
let's
how
skip the ad. You see the settings is now automatically is going to 240. Okay. This is the benefit of this extension. You will get always 240 resolution by this plugin. Okay. Let's cut this down. Now our Firefox is active. Now let's check our previous extensions works or not. We should go to google.com again. Google.com. Okay, now let's search our previous extensions. One was user, I searched user extension for Firefox. Okay. Its name is basically user agent switcher. Okay, this time addons.mozilla.org is coming. Now let's click it and go to this page. Okay, it says user agent switcher Firefox. I have to add this on Firefox. Let's add it. Okay, I think it's going to be added. Working. It's asking for add. I hit add. I hit okay. I think it's okay now. It's on my PC. Okay, it's done. Now let's take a new page and cut the previous page, and you see there a new icon is active. There you see a new icon. Difference between Chrome and Firefox is Chrome sets all its extension on a icon. You see that icon, an icon like that, and Firefox puts its extensions right here. So let's check it by whoware.net. whoware.net. Let's see what is our IP or address is really is. My IP is 10315140067 and it's Bangladesh and ICC communication. Now let's enable this extension. It looks quite not the same, but it works. It works. Now let's go to a sample website. Let's go to YouTube. This is the default look. I'm gonna, my line is slow, sorry for that. Now let's click it and go to Android, Android tablet Firefox. Okay. Now let's switch to this mode. Let's refresh this page. Let's see anything changes or not. No, drastically nothing changes, but let's check it with the whoware.net. What happens? Let's see. Is it work or not? Okay, it's ICC communication India and its OS is now, it's thinking is Android. Okay. Oh, I forgot to say that what is this thing 70%. This disgust means that my IP is far away from the main browser, so it is damaging or it is losing some packet. 30% of the data is lost or wasted. I'm not getting the directory speed. Okay, so this thing is coming. If I turn it off default, if I refresh it, you will see 100% disgust. That means I'm getting 100% direct connection. Okay, let it be load. I think that it's blocking still now. Okay, I think my browser have some problem now. So we have checked this plugin named Agent Chaser, User Agent Chaser. Now I don't need it, so I you see there is another option, Googlebot. Pretty much funny thing, there is option like Googlebot. Let's see what it says about Googlebot. You see, sorry, you have been blocked. This isn't right. Okay. We shouldn't do this. We back to default. Now refresh. Now it's back. So we shouldn't try with Googlebot. It's quite problem. Now we have to remove this thing, or we would. We can remove them later also. If you want to remove it, then go to here, click this three dot, and then go to add-ons on and themes, and you will find the add-ons here. Okay, I want to remove this. I click remove. And it shows. Now, we used another plugins named Auto Quality. Auto Quality for YouTube. Let's check how it works. It's for Chrome, but we have to find Firefox extension. Firefox. Okay. Auto Quality for YouTube. Firefox. Okay. Sorry. I pressed the wrong button. You see, the red software we used isn't available for Firefox. That was only for Chrome version. We have to use another website, okay, for that. Okay, let's hit add. Let's hit add. This is gonna enable this extension. Okay, okay, I hit okay. Let's see how it works. It's working. Oh, sorry, it's added. Now let's go to YouTube. Now here is the extension button. Oh my god, there's the problem. Sign up with Google, sign up with email. I have to sign up and I don't have some time to sign up, so I'm gonna remove this plugin. Sorry, extension. So as far we saw that it's best to play with Google Chrome. It's best for extensions. Many interesting extensions are there for Chrome. Okay, let's see. I have Auto Quality for YouTube. Now I remove it. It's removed. But hundreds and thousands of interesting plugins for